Hello, and welcome to day three of Automatica. Over the first 2 days of this trade show, we've already experienced live how the factory of the future controls itself and how humans shape those processes. And today, we'll be showing you several more innovations and technologies from companies that have the solutions for tomorrow. Our daily highlights. Yaskawa presents its new hybrid cobots. These robots can be used in industrial production, but can also work together with humans, just like colleagues. Teamwork at its best. We have a collaborative hybrid robot here, meaning the robot can work in cobot mode as well as in industrial mode. We achieve this by attaching a laser scanner here. The laser scanner detects the distance between human and robot and adjusts the speed accordingly. So if we're very far away from the robot, it travels at full speed, in this case 2 meters per second. And then I walk closer to the robot, it slows down a bit, and as soon as I stand beside it, it switches to collaborative mode and works at the safe collaborative speed. An industrial robot, on the other hand, would stop if I stood right next to it. Watch out, things are getting seriously fast, because here in Munich, Wyzo and Genesis Robotics present the fastest robot in the world.
It is definitely the fastest robot. Wyzo is what we call a sidebot. It's actually a new category of robot. It's a compromise between an industrial robot that can work at very high speed, up to 100 cycles per minute, and a collaborative robot that can work at a lower speed, the same speed, but it's significantly higher than the speed of a collaborative robot, which is probably in the range of 7 to 10 cycles a minute. And here we can work up to 30, 40 cycles a minute in full safe mode, which is 4 or 5 times faster than a regular collaborative robot.
Team Technik is a specialist for assembly and function testing systems. The focus is on new energy and e-mobility. Every electric drive of an e-vehicle undergoes an end-of-line test. What's special here is that Team Technik offers software and hardware, as well as assembly and testing, all from a single source. Fanuc is presenting its classic industrial robotics at Automatica. Like cobots, the large systems are becoming increasingly intelligent and easier to link, and they can move heavier loads, requirements that are especially relevant for e-mobility. The new R1000 behind me has been specially designed for everything to do with the electric vehicle. In this case, we see a battery cell from an electric vehicle, and they of course require payloads of around 1,000 kilos, so they can be properly handled and installed in the cars, and so we can get them electrified. Networked production close enough to touch, it's the standard of the future. OPC UA is becoming increasingly established in mechanical and plant engineering. The open interface enables digital networking, runs on numerous operating systems, and ensures cross-manufacturer compatibility. The VDMA special show, the Interoperability Showcase, presents relevant standards on 4 demonstrators. It's certainly worth stopping by here. And now, our daily talents. Imagine you want to integrate robotics into your production, but you don't have the know-how yet. No worries, you can now easily order everything online, Amazon style, including the consulting. It sounds crazy, but Unchained Robotics makes it possible. Unchained Robotics is an online platform for robots, for small and medium-sized factories. We help factories with no robot know-how to get to their first solution, and maybe even a second or third one. It's sort of like Uber for robots. We pick up the customer where he stands. We organize the whole process so that the customer reaches the goal of having the first robot in his factory. Well, those were the highlights for today. We'll see you again tomorrow and round off the show with the daily vision.
I think people get more and more tech savvy over time, and we get less and less scared about the technology as we understand more and more about it. But interestingly, robotics is only a robot until it becomes something specific. So, and that's the same for any technology, more or less. So my lawnmower at home is not a robot lawnmower. It's just a lawnmower that is going on its own. Similar with a vacuum cleaner. It's not. I mean, you still call them robot vacuum cleaners, but I think in some years we'll just call them vacuum cleaners. In self-driving cars, we still call cars. So even the robot technology is coming into all these different application areas. We still wouldn't really consider them robots. Because for us humans, robots is something scary and fascinating at the same time. Robot for us is some technology that looks like us and have the same dreams and ambitions, greed, power hunger that we do, and therefore in the end want to take over the world. But that's not what robotics really is. Robotics is just technology and how we use technology to make our lives easier, get more out of our time and energy.